everyone and welcome to my video lecture series. So our topic for today is the dihybrid test cross. So let us start with that. Now I have already made a video lecture on back cross and test cross. So if you haven't seen that video, kindly click on the link which you might be seeing on the top right hand most corner of the screen and watch that, and then you can watch this one. So over there in that video, I have shown the example of a monohybrid test cross, right, where we are selecting one character. Over here, we are going to select two characters because it is a dihybrid. So we are going to select the characters, height of the plant and shape of the seed. So the dihybrid, which I'm going to write down, that is going to be capital T, small t, capital R, small r, which is a tall and round hybrid, right? And please remember, a test cross is a cross in which the F1 hybrid is crossed with a recessive parent. So the recessive parent is going to be small t, small r, which is a dwarf and wrinkled parent. Is this clear? Correct? So let me write down over here. These are the parents. Okay, the next step is to basically find out the gamete. So how do you find out the gametes of a dihybrid? I have already told you, take one character at one time, right? Now let us take the height character. There are two alleles, so take any one allele from them and combine it with the allele from the next character. The next character is shape of the seed. Again, you have two alleles, so you can take any one allele. So from each character, take any one allele and combine it with the allele of another character. So by doing that, we basically get four gametes, and they are, I will write down them. The first gamete is going to be capital T, capital R, then capital T, small r, then there is going to be small t, capital R, and small t, small r. So these are the gametes which we are getting from the dihybrid. Now the other parent, if we consider small t, small r, then we can get only one type of gamete, that is going to be small t and small r. Is that clear? So let me write that down. So these are the gametes. Let us mention it over here. Okay. Now what do? We have to basically combine the gametes. So there are going to be four possibilities of the offspring. Okay. So the first possibility is when you are going to combine the capital T, capital R gamete with the small t, small r gamete, and you are going to get an organism called capital T, capital R, small r, right? The next possibility is combining capital T, small r with small t, small r. So you are going to get capital T, small t, small r, small r. Then the next possibility is going to be small t, capital R combined with small t, small r. So that is going to be small t, capital R, small r. And the last offspring is going to be small t, small r, small r. Is this clear? Okay. Now, all these offsprings which are formed, okay, these offsprings, now we have to find their genotypic and the phenotypic ratio. So first of all, let us write about the phenotypic ratio. So for that, we'll have to write down the phenotypes first. So this is a tall and round plant, correct? This is a tall and wrinkled plant. This is a dwarf and round plant. And this last one is a dwarf and wrinkled plant. So you are getting four different phenotypes. Okay. So the phenotypic ratio is going to be what? Can anybody guess and tell me? The phenotypic ratio is going to be 1:1:1:1. Is this clear? Because you are having four different types of phenotypes. If you want to write down the genotypic ratio, okay, what will be the genotypic ratio of this? Now, if you see the four offsprings, all of them are having different genotypes. All of them are having a different combination of alleles. So the genotypic ratio is also going to be the same 1 is to 1 is to 1 is to 1. So please remember, whether you are doing a monohybrid test cross or a dihybrid test cross, both the ratios, genotypic and phenotypic, will always remain the same. In the case of a monohybrid test cross, both the ratios are 1 is to 1. In the case of a dihybrid test cross, it is 1 is to 1 is to 1 is to 1. So that ends this part on the dihybrid test cross. I hope it is clear. If you like the lecture, please leave in a like. Do subscribe to my channel. Okay. Press the bell icon and also share this video with your friends. Thanks a lot.